Minister, Vice President, ladies and gentlemen, excellencies, it is my honor to wrap up very briefly this 3 days event and conference. As we run out of the time, I will try to be very, very brief. This is the third year of Prague European Summit. It's the third year, so we can already try to evaluate a bit. Here, I would mention one important thing, one important observation. What is the difference between the first and second year and the third year? And this, it is a change of mood, slight change in mood. From the very pessimist first and second year, we are slightly more optimistic the third year. But this slight optimism is just the beginning of a long journey, of a long way. And at the end of this long journey, there has to be tangible results. It was mentioned yesterday by the Deputy Foreign Minister Jakub Dürr that without the tangible result, the citizens will, or the EU will not regain the trust of its citizens. Now, what were the three words which were mentioned on all the panels of this Prague European Summit? Brexit, youth, and citizens. They were mentioned by all of us. I would like to take up on these three words. Brexit, of course, it is a dominant topic of our debates. From the debates and from what is happening in the EU, sometimes it looks like that the EU has already psychologically detached from the UK. Although it always in the history, it was other way around. So now the EU is detaching itself. Now, how to deal with the Brexit in a way that it doesn't repeat with other countries? And here I try to make a bridge toward the other two words, the youth and the citizens, and to concrete project, tangible results. Let me remind you that today we are celebrating a very important anniversary. It's 30 years from the moment when the Erasmus program started. I am from the generation of Erasmus students. I was in Spain back in 2002, and it was the best half year in my life. And I think in that moment, I gained my passion for the Europe, for the European Union. And it's one of the projects which are tangible, which are including young people. So here we have youth. Another important anniversary was yesterday, 32 years from signing the Schengen Agreement. The freedom of movement, it is the project which is tangible, which all the citizens can enjoy. And today, it's also a very important day, as I said during the first day of the conference. Today, for the first time, we can travel in the Europe and we don't have to pay roaming charges. And it is the tangible result. It is something what the citizens, the third world, they can somehow grasp and enjoy, and they can connect it with the European integration. So here to stop about the concluding remarks and now some figures. So this is the third year of the conference, of the Prague European Summit. It lasted for 3 days. It involved three Prague public talks. It involved 12 partners and media partners, 18 panels, 84 speakers, and more than 500 participants. I would like to thank especially to the partners of the conference. You can see their logos here everywhere, but one special thank to our strategic partners, the Ministry of Foreign Affairs of the Czech Republic, because without this strategic partner, the Prague European Summit would never take place. I would like to thank also to organizing team, Nelly, Lucia, Bara, Clara, Susan, Linda, Philip, Alex, and many others. Without you, we wouldn't be able to deliver such a great conference. So I would like now to ask also the audience to really show our gratitude to the organizing team. When we deliberated the idea of the Prague European Summit, there was many reasons why we wanted to organize it. I will mention only two of them, so why we are here. First, we wanted to put Prague back on the European map of the cities, of the countries, where the discussion on the European issues is sincere and frank, and we wanted to show that the Czech Republic is a pro-European country, is not a hole in the donut, as I said during the first year of the conference. So that's one important reason. And the second important reason was that we realized that there is nothing like Prague European Summit so far. It's very surprising. There are many other conferences, security conferences, economic conferences, but nothing really regular on the European Union itself, on the European integration. And you know, if something happens once, it's a coincidence. If something happens twice, it might be a coincidence, but if something happens three times, it will happen the fourth, the fifth, the sixth. So I hope, truly hope, this is also the case of the Prague European Summit. So let me invite you for the next year of the Prague European Summit, again, most probably here in June. And let me also invite you to the glass of wine offered in the gardens of the palace, where we can toast to the next year's summit. Thank you.